Starting with the first one, we're lifting from the front bumper. So we're lifting here. And we've got 300 at this point, and 2500 here. Now, if we're lifting from the front bumper, the car is going to pivot around the back wheel here. So for that first one, the total distance of F from the pivot is here. That's 1.2 plus 0.7, that's 1.9. And I've got to get these distances as well. 1.3. And this one is 1.7. So 1.9F is going to equal 300 times 1.7 plus 2500 times 0.3. Write that one out first. So 260 divide that by 1.9 and I get 663. Okay. The next one, it's quite similar really. Pivot now moves. So I'm looking from the back of the car. And pivot ends up on the front wheel, so I'm lifting from the back here, and the pivot's here. So I've got a different set of distances now, 1 meter here, 0.4 meters here, and F is 0.8 plus 1.4. Okay, so this time though, the 300 is acting in the same rotational direction as F. They're both acting anti-clockwise. So 1.2F plus 300 times 1 equals 2500 times 0.4. So 1.2F equals 2500 times 0.4. Minus 300 times 1, that's 700. That's 700 divided by 1.2. And that gives me 583. Now, for the last one, it's a bit different. We don't need the diagram anymore, we're lifting from the side, we need sort of a new diagram. So the car, let's imagine we've got sort of headlights of the car here, and two wheels here. So we're lifting from one side, and we've got both the forces acting down from the center of the car. The combined weight of 2,800, and the pivot is the other wheel on the opposite side. That's going to simply be double the force required because it's twice the distance away. So that's going to be 5,600. No, sorry, it's not going to be double, it's going to be half. What am I thinking? Okay.